Never start one of your presentations from scratch ever again with PowerPoint's own auto design feature and outside websites and tools that offer free templates. Plus, we have some bonus design tips for you guys to use while you're starting a PowerPoint from scratch or whether you're customizing one of those templates. Teachers make a lot of presentations for their students. However, not all teachers are graphic designers with the time to put together creative, well-balanced PowerPoints every single time. To help make that design process a little bit easier, you can use PowerPoint's Design Ideas feature. This feature will totally upgrade your PowerPoint presentation and that design with just the click of a button. However, you do have to be an Office 365 subscriber to have access to this feature, or you can use the online version like we are here. To start using this tool, you guys can just start adding some text or images to your slide, and the side panel will appear with design ideas, but if it doesn't, you guys can click the Designer tab here in your Home button, or in the Design tab up here, you can click the Designer button and the side panel will open, giving you lots of different ideas that you can scroll through, or you can always see more if you don't like any of those. If you do see one that you like, you can just go ahead and click on it and it will automatically update your slides. So this works on a title slide or any of your other content slides. Now your students are a little bit more intrigued, you have a more visually appealing slide that will hold their attention a little bit longer. I mean, honestly, which slide would you rather be looking at? PowerPoint Design Ideas is great, but if you don't mind leaving PowerPoint to get even more creative, there are quite a few websites that offer free downloadable templates. And many of these have templates just for teachers. So some of our favorites are Canva, which is a tool for creating and designing your very own presentations, templates, and other graphics for your class. It is super easy to become a graphic designer with this tool. Canva does have a huge library of different options to choose from, so you may have to do a couple more edits than you would in some of the other tools that we mentioned later. Some of the edits that you can do here are changing different colors in your presentation, changing different images and the text and the fonts, but if you want to know more about Canva, we do have a link up above to a video all about Canva and using it in your classroom. So once all of your designs are completed, you can go ahead and present it right in Canva through to your students, or you can go ahead and download this and save it as a PowerPoint file. That way you can add some more interactivity with tools like ClassPoint to better engage your students. As an educator, you do get Canva for Education for free, which is access to the Canvas Pro version that allows you more access to features, icons, graphics, and templates. Buncee is another one of our favorite template tools. Buncee has a ton more education-focused templates than Canva does, so you guys can scroll through and see how many different templates that they have. And once you find one that you like, you can begin using it. Buncee is designed for you to create and edit and add anything right in this tool and then present or share to your students right from here. They have lots of different items that you can add into your slide. And once you've completed all of your customizing, you can go ahead, share it to your students through the app here, or you guys can always download the slides as images and put them into a PowerPoint presentation for that better interactivity as well. However, you're gonna miss out on a lot of their 3D images and videos that they have that you can insert into these templates. Buncee has both a pro version and a free version. No matter what, when you sign up, you get a month free on that pro version, which has a ton more access to templates, but the free version is nice and easy and you can still use as well. SlidesGo is another one of our favorites that you can use. It is a little bit more geared towards elementary students. However, their templates not only have a wide range of designs, graphics, and colors to choose from, but they often already have information and activities that are already in their slides. So it's definitely geared towards educators. So you can just go ahead and search up a template that you want to use. And you can click on it, scroll through, see if you like it, and choose to download it as a Google Slides or as a PowerPoint file. Once in PowerPoint, just plug in your own information, make any customizations that you want, and you're ready to go with a fresh, professionally looking PowerPoint designed for your class. The only downfall here is that there is only 10 free downloads per month, so use them sparingly. And lastly, I just want to mention two other tools, Slide Carnival, which has great design decks, but not all education focused, and Twinkle, which has an abundance of teacher resources, not just presentations. So it may take a little bit more time to find exactly what you're looking for. But any of these tools you guys can use as templates to kickstart your PowerPoint design process. Once you've chosen a template, it's now time to completely upgrade and customize that to make it your own. When you're doing that, keep these tips and ideas in mind. Number one, color. So color is important to keep balance throughout your whole presentation. So if you want to upgrade the color and you need some ideas on what goes well together, you can use Canva. You can search up any colors that you want, and it will provide a whole bunch of different options and palettes that you can use to implement into your presentation. We also like using Color Hunt because it has a wide variety of options. So if you're looking for something a little bit darker, or if you want something a little bit brighter, you can go ahead and look at all of those different options. Next up is fonts. So when you're adding text to your PowerPoint slides, remember less is more. Only keep those key points on there. Think about six bullets or six words across. That way it keeps it concise and simple for your audience. When you're working on a PowerPoint presentation, you will want to embed your fonts. That way, when you go ahead and share it with others, the layout and everything will stay the same. To make sure that your PowerPoint is doing that, just go into File and Options, and then click on the Save tab over here. Scroll down to the bottom and make sure Embed Fonts in the File is checkmarked. Then you can just click OK and you're all set. Some places to look at free fonts if you don't like the ones that PowerPoint offers are Google Fonts, which has so many different options. We also like Urban Fonts and Font Squirrel. So you guys can take a look at those if you're ever in need of a little bit of a change up. With that text on your slide, not only is the font important, but the size is important as well. You want to try to keep less on the slide, make that font size a little bit bigger than having a lot of words at such a small size. This way, you can intermix different icons and graphics into your slide. Which brings us to number three, which is images. It's really important to show your audience and your students visual representation throughout your slides. So PowerPoint has images online that you guys can use when you insert things right from here. But if you're looking for something a little bit more creative, you can also use some of these sites here. We like to use Pexels, Pixabay, and also Unsplash to look at different stock photos. These are all free and free to use throughout your different lessons and different sharings. You can put them in videos, so they're copyright free and free for you guys to use and download. You can also use Google to search up images, but when you're doing that, remember if you want to put it into your PowerPoint presentation, make sure that you are searching with a Creative Commons license. That way you don't have any copyright issues. If you're already using Canva for getting your template, you can also use any of their images that they have in their library, which makes it super easy and useful to just do everything all at once in there. Besides images, icons are also a great interaction and graphic to add into your PowerPoint slides. So PowerPoint actually does have different icons that you can customize, change the color and change the size as well. But a lot of the template tools that we mentioned before, Canva, SlidesGo, Buncee, they all have icons that kind of go with their templates as well that you guys are free to use. But if nothing is catching your eye, you can always use Flat Icon, which will help with lots of different icons, and you'll definitely be able to find something that you want to implement into your slides. And once all of those images and graphics are in your PowerPoint slides, don't forget that you guys can edit them right inside of PowerPoint. If you want tips on how to remove the background of an image right in PowerPoint, go ahead and check out that video. For more tips like this, subscribe to our channel, and that way you can also learn about the interactive tool that we mentioned before, ClassPoint. I'm Sarah Famicno. It was a pleasure designing with you guys today. If you do want to learn more about creating better presentations, go ahead and check out adding in some interactivity with these PowerPoint add-ins or adding in some different animations into your PowerPoint presentations.